0060 y estoy ahora aquí con mi amigo y colega Jorge Coughlin. ¿Cómo estás, Jorgito, allá en California, no? Disfrutando.
Bueno, como siempre, California, un día muy bonito comparado con el resto del clima que hay, creo, en la parte este, pero por eso es que en estas épocas del año vienen a correr por aquí en Phoenix. Ahora le toca California Speedway, conocido como Fontana, donde perdió la vida un gran piloto canadiense de IndyCar, Greg Moore, por eso lo recordamos mucho, pero ahora con esto de la NASCAR, con los nuevos autos de la generación 6, sexta generación, parece que tienen un buen auto en sus manos para poder retomar esos viejos días en que los duelos eran espectaculares.
Bueno, ¿qué es lo que se ha visto hasta ahora en la temporada de la NASCAR, ¿no? En realidad bastante carreras muy cerradas, todos los pilotos tienen aparentemente los autos muy a punto, muy bien puestos, y la diferencia a veces del lugar 1 al 30 son un segundo, medio segundo.
Es muy emocionante, es muy emocionante el poder ver cómo estos gladiadores modernos, a una precisión que necesitas a 200 millas por hora, no es broma. Por afuera parece que fuera como ir a correr las Olimpiadas y llegan a los 100 metros planos y dicen, bueno, están corriendo, pero llegar ahí tú sabes lo que cuesta, ¿no? Y además lo que toma de poder sacrificarte y saber correr y llegar ahí, ¿no?
Claro, porque la gente lo ve y la mayoría de estas carreras son en óvalos y entonces creen que simplemente poner la mano en el timón y en cierto ángulo y el auto va dando vueltas, pero no hay mucha habilidad envuelta en todo esto. Y Jorge, cuéntanos entonces, van a estar transmitiendo en Fox Deportes en español para Estados Unidos, ¿no?
Esto es un gran logro. Esto es un gran logro. Significa que nuestra comunidad, para mí significa ya que hemos llegado. Porque para que NASCAR, que es muy americano, muy gringo, muy redneck, como le llaman, para que NASCAR y ahora Fox Deportes, que es mucho fútbol, Messi, Barça, Real Madrid, fútbol mexicano, el Chivas, el Cruz Azul, el América, entonces para que ellos hagan estas transmisiones de NASCAR, carreras de autos al mercado latino en directo, en realidad yo como aficionado hace años que lo esperaba,
claro.
Pero ellos no, ellos veían básquet, béisbol, college football, fútbol americano, ¿no es cierto? Veían todo eso como lo que hay que transmitir para los hispanos,
claro.
Y yo decía, oye, nosotros nos gustan los autos de carrera, tenemos la Panamericana, tenemos los hermanos Rodríguez,
y hay gran afición
a Fangio, tenemos el gran premio argentino, Caminos del Inca, la Buenos Aires, Caracas. Nosotros estamos en la República Dominicana, es donde más Porsche se venden en toda Latinoamérica. Nosotros tenemos una gran afición por los autos.
Bueno, pues así ahora en Fox Deportes en español, aquí para Estados Unidos, la NASCAR con Jorge Coughlin. Muchas gracias, Jorge, por tu tiempo. Vamos a estarte siguiendo ahí durante las carreras el fin de semana entonces. Muchas gracias, ¿eh?
Gracias a ti, estamos en vivo.
Gracias, Jorge Coughlin, ahí desde California para la carrera de la NASCAR. Y ahora de California vamos a Detroit y del español al inglés. Now we'll go from California to Detroit and from Spanish to English to talk to John McCormick from the World Car of the Year Awards. How are you, John?
I'm good, thank you.
Thank you very much for taking the time to talk to us about the awards that are going to be presented next week at the Auto Show in New York, right?
That's correct, on Thursday morning.
Yeah, John McCormick, he's director of the steering committee of the World Car of the Year Awards, which it's a very important award. I think the manufacturers really expected with a lot of anxiety to see how it is. And there's, can you explain a little bit about the history of these awards? I think it's been a few years already since they started, right?
Yes, we've been going for 9 years now, and we're the only global awards program that recognizes cars across the globe. It's a fairly complicated process because, of course, some cars are different in different markets, but we try and straighten all it out and give an award for what we think is the best car of the year, and then some subcategories for performance, green car, and design.
Yeah. So for the car of the year, we have the Mercedes-Benz A-Class. We were talking to Christian Busch from Mercedes-Benz actually in the first segment of the show. This car is not available in the States. Then you have the Porsche, the both variants, the Boxer and the Cayman. Cyan, which is a double car, like a twin car with a VRC from a Subaru and a Cyan FRS, and in other parts of the world it's called the Toyota 86 or GT 86, and then the Volkswagen Golf. And Volkswagen has been in your top list for a few years, right?
Yes, Volkswagen's done well. The Up scored a victory before the Volkswagen Up, which is not sold in the US. It's a small subcompact. The Golf, obviously, is a very strong contender, being such a long-lived car and so widely sold around the world. So, you know, quite big expectations for that car. But the Boxster and Cayman are very strong contenders. I think in the new generation, they've really improved a great deal.
Yeah, some people say that it's better than the 911.
Yeah, there is some of that. And the 911 has won a performance award from us before. So, but no, indeed, the Cayman and Boxster really come forward in their latest generation. And also the Toyota 86 and the Subaru BRZ is really an interesting contender, especially from Toyota. I mean, you could argue that it shows that Toyota can actually produce a car that's fun to drive. So
exactly.
It's a really exciting car.
Yeah, and then on the Sports Award, the Sports Car of the Year Award, you also have the Boxster, the Cayman, the Cyan, and the VRC, and the Ferrari F12 Berlinetta. Can you explain a little bit of how those categories and have the same candidates?
Well, it's just a way we select an overall list of candidates for all categories, and then you know, some cars naturally double up, come to the top. You know, a car like the Toyota is a sports car, but is also a general a car for the masses, if you like. So it can fall into both categories. Obviously, the Ferrari is such an exclusive car that it would be not eligible for something like World Car. So that's how it works. And the Boxster and Cayman are also, you know, accessible sports cars, relatively speaking, so that they fall into the World Car category as well.
Yeah, it's good. Then you have the green car of the year, and you have one model that is not sold in the U.S., the Renault Zoe, and then the Model S from Tesla, and the Volvo plug-in hybrid V60. That's a pretty interesting category. I think if I didn't vote, I'm not part of the judging, but I see good chances for the Tesla. I don't know. What do you think?
Well, yes, Tesla has come to the forefront with, you know, some other awards. For I think Most Trends gave it an award, and it seems to have been attracting a lot of attention, even though of course not in production yet. We do have in our World Car of the Year category, you have to be in production and actually on sale in two continents in the world at least. The Tesla, you know, may be great because it is a very interesting car and has seemed to attract a lot of positive attention from the media.
Yeah, and I mean, these cars, the U.S. has the most stringent requirements for safety and all those things. So, and these cars technically could be sold anywhere in the world, right? But it's not yet in every market.
Yeah, I mean, I think the thing with Tesla, of course, is a very small company, and they have to walk before they run, and you know, so selling in other markets is going to take a while, and you know, there's a lot of bridges to be crossed for that company in various ways before they can expand that far.
Yeah, and then finally, you have the Design Award of the Year, and you have the Aston Martin Vanquish and the Jaguar F-Type, the new model from the British company.
Yes, and also the Mazda 6. I think it's interesting, I'm just driving a Mazda 6 press car at the moment, and it is a very striking design. And I like the way that some companies are making mid-sized sedan designs more interesting.
Yeah.
And Mazda's one of them. It's a very sleek-looking car.
Yeah. What a coincidence, because I also have a Mazda 6. Mine is red. What color is yours?
My one is white, and it looks good in white.
Actually, I posted some pictures on my Facebook page yesterday on the red one, so I invite you to check them out.
Yes, indeed, yeah. But it's up against some pretty heavy competition in the F-Type and the Vanquish, of course. The F-Type is an interesting car in itself. You know, Jaguar is going through a sort of whole sea change of design from its classic years, and the F-Type is definitely stepping out from, you know, the old days of the E-Type and so on. So it'll be interesting to see how that does too.
Very interesting. So next week in New York, I'm going to see you there, and thank you personally for this interview and your time. And we'll see who it wins in this for Gregory's.
I look forward to it. Thank you very much, Elliot.
Thank you very much, John McCormick from the World Car of the Year Awards Committee. Y ahí estaba la entrevista con John McCormick del comité del jurado del Auto Mundial del Año, el único premio mundial que se va a entregar la próxima semana en el Auto Show de Nueva York, y estaremos ahí con los ganadores. Auto Mundial del Año, Auto Deportivo del Año, Auto Verde del Año, perdón, y el Diseño Automotriz del Año. Y bueno, ahora cuando regresemos en Auto 060, en el último segmento de este show, vamos a hablar de una iniciativa muy interesante que tiene la Scion, que tiene uno de los candidatos al Auto Deportivo del Año y al Auto del Año, sobre un programa que se llama Motivate, y esto es para impulsar a empresarios jóvenes a desarrollar sus carreras. Y este es otro aspecto de la industria automotriz que a veces conversamos, y es muy interesante hablar de ellos, porque los fabricantes de autos no solamente están dedicados al negocio puro y duro de hacer dinero con los autos que venden, sino que también están apoyando a las comunidades, y en este caso van a escuchar lo que tiene que ofrecer la Scion con este programa que se llama Motivate. Esto es Auto 060 y ya regresamos. Yo soy Javier Mota. De antemano, gracias a DJ Cafa y por la ayuda en los controles.